someone would have told me that that was worship, then I would have just been like, that's not worship. That's just what I do. That's quiet time before the Lord and I. This is kind of a hilarious story, but my older sister, she's firstborn. She was very musical. I mean, can write music, can play the guitar, taught herself how to do all these things. She was a musician. She was the one that when she sang, you froze. She had this soprano voice, and she wanted vocal lessons, and she wanted piano lessons. And literally, I remember thinking at, 10 and 11, I don't want her to have a talent I can't accomplish better. So I literally took piano lessons and a few vocal lessons out of sheer jealousy over my older sister, who was very thin and looked like Marcia Brady and seemed to have it all to me. I was always very kind of closed off, and I was very dramatic but internal at the same time. And I thought, I'm going to be an actress. I would love to play characters even in plays and that had a worse off time than I did, because I felt like I could just revel in glory in that role. It was kind of like a break for my life. Worship was never anything. It just was what I did when I was home and had to rehearse for those piano lessons, or I would have the school bus drop me off at my mother's job, which was the secretary for our church. And I, to wait for her before she got off, would go into that dark sanctuary that only was lit by the stained glass windows that lined the side. And I would sit on that grand piano and I would write. And I would just sit there for hours and cry, not know why, but I started just writing letters to the Lord on the piano. But I think that's where I was worshiping and I didn't know I was worshiping. There are a lot of people in our community of believers in the church that I was attending at that point in my late teens and 20s that would hear me sing, and they would say something about, oh my gosh, you should do this, you should make a record. Well, that was kind of foreign to me because it wasn't the throbbing of the heart in my heart, the beat of my heart. Acting was. I had this conversation with the Lord one night, and he said, I want you to stop acting in your life. And he said, you know, when you act because you love being somebody else in character. And I thought, you're right. When I sing, I'm singing solely and completely and for the Lord. When I'm acting, I'm doing it because I want people to clap. I want people to say, she's so good at that. I didn't care about that in the worship. And of it, because I was like, it was never for the people. It was always for the Lord. It just reshaped my entire, direction, for sure. I didn't start leading on the main stage. This position opened up for the kindergartners. And the Lord said, I want you to lead worship in here. This is the best congregation you'll ever have. Leading worship for children, for me, just demolished the barriers. It fortified the fact that when I sat alone and the presence of God came, it was all about the Lord. And when I led worship in front of the kids, it was really all about the Lord. And when you look at these little kids, they weren't judging you. They weren't wondering what you were wearing or if you were wearing the coolest thing or whether your lyrics were okay or congregational. They just wanted you to lead them where they could dance and lead them to worship. And so if someone doesn't like my style of leading worship, I know the Lord, well, according to him, he grabs his chest when I lead worship. He can hardly contain himself. So all of a sudden, my insecurities don't matter much because I know what he thinks about me. That's all I really need. I think that's, for me at least, where I rest, because nobody says it quite like the Lord anyway.